Did you know that more than one third of the elements in the periodic table of elements are classified as a critical in EU? Either because of geopolitical reasons or because of their forecasted need compared to their abundance in the Earth crust. And many of these elements are used in energy storage devices. For example, lithium-ion batteries, which we have today in everyday use in our mobile phones, and also devices which are used in emerging hydrogen technologies. And these technologies are really needed to enable the transition, the ongoing transition from fossil-based fuels towards renewables. The sun is not always shining, and the wind is not always blowing. So we sometimes have excess supply of energy from renewables, and sometimes the energy production is not able to meet our needs. To level off these differences, we need energy storage. And it has been forecasted that in the next 20 years, the need for energy storage capacity will increase 50 times from the current level. Electrochemical energy conversion and storage technologies are versatile, flexible, and scalable. Hence, we can use them for storing energy. They can be used in very many different applications. For example, lithium-ion batteries are used today in mobile phones, but they can also really enable the electrification of traffic and then cutting the local emissions. If you think about the hydrogen technologies, those are very suitable for large-scale energy storage in the connection of windmill parks or solar cell parks, for example. So all these electrochemical energy conversion and storage technologies have their own benefits and drawbacks. And to really have a suitable energy storage device for all situations, we need to develop them in parallel. How about then the critical raw materials? If we think about the lithium-ion batteries, which we have in our everyday use in mobile phones, there we have natural graphite in the negative electrode, which is classified as a critical. We have phosphor in the electrolyte and cobalt in the positive electrode, not to mention lithium. All these are classified as critical. But if we really consider the sustainability of the lithium-ion batteries, we need to take into account also the production, mining of the raw materials, the processing, and synthesizing of chemicals for lithium-ion batteries. All this consumes energy and produces emissions, and so does recycling of the batteries. So to really make the lithium-ion batteries more sustainable, we need to also increase their lifetime without sacrificing the performance. And many research organizations and industrial companies are doing investigation on these materials to increase the sustainability of the lithium-ion batteries. We also contribute to this work. We have been developing nickel-rich positive electrode materials, which contain only a small amount of cobalt. And we have used Finnish Innovation ALD to coat them. The coating protects the electrodes from aging. And aging is a complex phenomena. It contains different kinds of electrochemical side reactions and also swelling and shrinking of the electrodes. These volume changes take place when we charge and discharge the batteries, because then we insert and take out lithium from the electrodes. This coating layer, it hinders the side reactions, but it also reduces the volume changes by one decade. With these changes, the battery can be used for a long time, yet its efficiency is similar. If we charge and discharge the batteries under similar conditions, the capacity, the energy storage capacity, remains at a higher level in the batteries which use the coated electrodes. And for this reason, we can use the battery with the same energy storage properties for a longer time. So this kind of research is done for the lithium-ion batteries which are in use today. How about then the emerging hydrogen technology? There we are facing similar issues. Storing of excess electrical energy from the renewables as a hydrogen bond energy is an electrochemical reaction, and it requires some catalyst to enhance the reaction. These catalyst materials are critical raw materials as well. We use their platinum group metals, which are scarce and expensive. So also here we need to find ways to reduce the amount of critical elements without sacrificing the device performance and yet increasing its lifetime to really make hydrogen technology sustainable. Our approach here has been to develop new type of catalyst materials to catalyze the hydrogen reactions. We have used nanostructured carbon, which has a graphitic carbon structure. This carbon is more durable than the conventional carbons, and hence it enables longer lifetime of the device. This carbon here serves as a support to spread the platinum. And we have coated the nanostructured carbon with a very thin layer of platinum, so that the platinum is well accessible for the hydrogen reactions. When using this material in the cells, we can get reasonable efficiency, but only with 1/10 of the platinum loading. So to really enable renewable energy-based future, we need to solve issues related to use of critical raw materials. And at the same time, we need to also solve issues related to device lifetime. And I would like to invite you all to continue this very important work with us. Thank you.